Hello and welcome to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos DLC. I've been waiting to play this. I kind of got interrupted by Cyberpunk 2077, if I remember correctly. We played Paralon Gorgon. I finished that around November of 2020. At this point, I'm recording this, it is mid-August of 2022. So, no one's asked for it, but we're going to be playing Murder on Eridanos. Hopefully people are interested in watching that. And my settings are weird. Oh, what happened? That's not acceptable settings. Okay. Otherwise, yeah, I had the audio, the master at 80. Controls should be the same. Maybe not. Well, let's go into it and see. So, players who have reached level 30 or higher. To begin your adventure in Eridanos, you must have gained access to the landing pad in Stellar Bay, which we have. After getting access to this area, return to your ship and talk to Ada. Your new adventure will start. So, level 30, I am level 33. So, this should be exciting. Been so long. Okay, so it says WASD, but I'm still able to move with arrow keys. That's our robot friend. We got stuff up here. Oh, look at that. Not sure if I saw that up there. Look at all that noise. This? I'm not completely sure. Okay, so we're running, jumping.
Sanitizing within established range.
I can't take out my gun on the ship. Oh, I can. Oh, that's that. The other one's reload, I think. And then, gotta keep hitting that. Stop hitting that. Okay, that's that. And then, how do you put the gun away? How do I put the gun away? I think that's all I need to know. Holding R, alright. Alright, I'm holding R. Hitting that again. Oh, I hit that again.
Impeccable timing, Captain. I was about to watch the latest episode in Halcyon Helen's thrilling serial adventure.
For inventory? Oh, wow. That was slowish. Wow. I do not even recognize my character. So, as far as these things, let's see, there's a medical thing. Don't need to worry about taking this too many times. I still have 407 of them. Alright.
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance?
You mentioned an ether wave drama? I'd like to see it.
Certainly, Captain. I was hoping you would ask.
Rizzo's presents Murder on Eridanos. Halcyon Helen versus the Brain Eaters, Chapter 12. Starring Ruth Bellamy as Halcyon Helen. Ruth Bellamy? Sounds familiar.
Was the law forsaken parasites?
Huh. It's black and white.
I had become obsessed. My quest to stop them. To avenge my partner, Philip. And my ex-partner, Bernice.
Oh.
And Lieutenant Jurgen. And those two informants had brought me to Rizzo's distillery.
Frank Rizzo, jerky.
But it wasn't just the triple distilled deliciousness of Rizzo's Spectrum brand vodka that I found there.
Skittering. Ouch.
It was death.
Death.
I made sure the Brain Eaters paid the price.
Brain Eaters? They kind of look like Ferengi, but with weird stuff coming out of their heads. Like tendrils coming out of their head? She heard a thudding sound, and footsteps are approaching. And it is?
It's you.
It is you?
This is the Halcyon News Network with breaking news. Halcyon Helen has been murdered. Administrator Ludovico of Rizzo's refused to answer the big question on everyone's mind. Who will Spectrum Vodka's next spokesperson be? Claiming that a special investigation must be concluded first.
Okay.
Captain, we have a communication coming in from one Administrator Ludovico.
Get off the transmission, Cedric. We agreed to let me do the negotiating.
Cedric?
Lobby with you, friend. I am Administrator Ludovico of the famed Eridanos Atmospheric Complex. But there's no need to stand on formality. You may address me as Mr.
How about I just call you Lou?
How about not?
Okay, Lou.
I apologize if I've struck too familiar a tone for your tastes. Let me get right to the point.
Well, I didn't say that.
Halcyon Helen is dead. Murdered.
Yeah, I just heard.
Her death is the tragedy of our lifetime. As the face of our new product line, her murder is a stain on the Rizzo's brand. She was scheduled to unveil our newest product, Spectrum Brown, before this tragic event. But we cannot move forward with our unveiling until we apprehend the killer.
Who's Halcyon Helen? Yeah, he's gonna be like, what? You haven't heard of him? But I wanted to hear, like, as much about her as possible. Yeah, who is Halcyon Helen?
You can't be serious.
I'm deadly serious.
Halcyon Helen, greatest cultural icon of our colony, Empress of the Aether Waves.
All right, Ludovico, that's enough. You don't know what you're doing. Let me handle this.
That's Cedric.
Captain Hawthorne, Sublight's favorite freelancer.
Favorite?
I'm such an admirer of your work. Cedric Kincannon, Sublight Underground. I'm so glad we're hiring a third-party investigator. No one wants to see a troop of UDL guards stomping all over my hotel. Least of all me. The murder of Halcyon Helen is a heinous assault on this colony. I look forward to watching you find the miscreant responsible and drag them out of the shadows.
I've never heard of Sublight Underground.
Don't worry. You and I are going to become very close acquaintances. I run the Grand Colonial Hotel and Piraeus Spaceport. Ludovico and I are business partners, in a manner of speaking. Eridanos is our shared responsibility.
Eridanos is not our shared responsibility. Eridanos is my responsibility, to which you and your organization have latched on like a parasite.
Oh my.
Please, Lou. Sublight Underground is built on discretion.
He calls him Lou, too.
I'm establishing rapport with our new contractor. Let's not give her the impression that you can't be trusted.
Do you really want to do this right now, Cedric? You want to antagonize me while I'm negotiating a contract? Because I promise you, I'll win.
Let them argue.
We can do this anytime you want. I'll even make an appointment. I'm sure your schedule's wide open. What with your product launch being indefinitely delayed due to unforeseen murder.
All right, Cedric. If that's how you want to behave, I have no choice but to file an official reprimand on your permanent record.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Please do. I'd love an official reprimand from a failed executive. Could you do me a favor and have it laminated?
Could we please stop this nonsense?
Oh.
Captain, I'm Hello. Constable Maria Keene. Hiring a third-party investigator was my idea. I've been studying your dossier. You're a talented diplomat. You know well, how to ask questions, and you have a gift for getting answers without resorting to violence.
Aw, shucks.
As far as I'm concerned, you're the ideal inspector for this case.
Just how many people are involved in this communication?
Just the three of us.
Just the three? No one else is going to jump in here unexpectedly?
You must excuse us. The situation on Eridanos is tense. If we don't bring Helen's killer to justice, this scandal could scupper our entire operation.
Scupper?
Please, Captain. I'm asking you to help us. While you're pursuing your investigation, we'll make you a guest of honor at the Grand Colonial.
That's the first time I've ever heard that word, scupper. Oh, come lounge around and I'll decide.
I encourage you to consider this offer seriously.
Yes.
The future of our complex may depend on your success. I'll leave you in the constable's care.
Oh, goody.
Mr. Kincannon and I must have a word.
Yeah.
Fine. Bud Rizzo's is paying for that hotel room.
I can't tell you how grateful I am for your help. And even though they may not show their gratitude, I know Administrator Ludovico and Mr. Kincannon appreciate your involvement. Mr. Kincannon could lose his spaceport if board authorities took over the investigation. And if Rizzo's is forced to cancel its unveiling, we might never recover.
Well, you seem competent. You could have dealt with this. I actually want to say both of these, at least. Yeah, you could have dealt with this, couldn't you?
I represent the law, Captain. But what's happening between Mr. Kincannon and the Administrator is politics. Politics are not my area of expertise. The law is simple. Politics are complicated.
Well, I'm not a politician either, you know. Well, you do sound a bit worn out.
Me? Worn out? Perish the notion. My days are filled with catering to the oh-so-reasonable requests of Mr. Ludovico and Mr. Kincannon. What's not to like?
That might be a little extreme. Them, actually. They're not very likable.
Your words, not mine. Please don't take my lack of disagreement as anything other than fatigue. I am a content, productive, and happy member of our society.
Well, those two seem to have some issues.
The Administrator oversees Rizzo's operations. Cedric runs the hotel and the spaceport. They're always at each other's throats. My life would be so much easier if they'd simply learn to work together.
Well, they're nothing I can't handle.
I'm pleased to hear that. From everything I've heard, you're a competent freelancer. And at the risk of sounding impertinent, we desperately need the help of someone competent. Thank you for your time, Captain. Whenever you're ready, I've authorized the Unreliable to land at the Grand Colonial.
Alright, I've got everything I need.
Transmission terminated. Captain, we are now cleared to land at the Eridanos Atmospheric Complex.
What can you tell me about Eridanos?
Eridanos is a hydrogen-helium gas giant, distinguished by a well-defined ring system.
Oh, and I'm landing on that.
The Eridanos Atmospheric Complex is a system of land masses propelled through a thin layer of the upper atmosphere, where humans are potentially capable of surviving.
Potentially capable of surviving? Okay, well, I don't know why they're trusting me to catch Halcyon Helen's killer.
There are several reasons why someone would hire your services. In descending order of likelihood, they are as follows.
Okay.
Desperation, confusion, mistaken identity, inebriation, and genuine faith in your abilities.
Thanks, Ada. Eridanos, here we come. AG-211, Eridanos, Halcyon's second Jovian gas giant. Its atmosphere is rich with hydrogen, helium, and various noble gases. Distillation plants in the atmosphere harvest these gases for energy. Interesting. On Eridanos, we are going to Eridanos.
We've arrived in Eridanos.
Anything else I can ask you?
Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? I'll be here.
I wonder if we can talk to people about Eridanos about this.
I can't believe Ms. Helen's gone.
Yeah.
Feels like it's going against the laws of nature somehow. I used to watch Helen's serials. She'd fall into mortal peril every couple episodes, but she always lived in the end.
I'm glad I could take you to see Eridanos. How's it feel? Of course, you're just sitting here in the hangar.
Breathtaking. Have you looked over the edge of the complex yet? Just watch the clouds turning? It's like an ocean without end.
I haven't yet, but I'm sure it really is something.
Eridanos and Olympus are the two biggest planets in Halcyon. King and queen of the sky. Looking out to the horizon, I get this feeling that we're in the company of royalty. Eridanos is 100 times the mass of Terra 2, 800 times the volume, 10 times the diameter. We're flying through the tiniest layer of habitable atmosphere. Sometimes I can't believe how small my world used to be. My horizons were about as wide as the walls of Edgewater.
And now look at you, on top of the world.
Yeah. We've come a long way.
Alright, let's talk to the others. I don't remember what their strengths and weaknesses are. So I'm probably just going to arbitrarily pick two people. This normally happens. You get two people to come with you. Hi.
Does being on the case give us temporary immunity? Think they'll let us confiscate a few stray bits? Something on your mind?
Nope.
Scanning for C. 2, 5, 4, 7. Grade rated contaminants.
Alright, back to work. Oh, no need to get up on my account.
I know we got a murder to solve, but I say we take our time. Enjoy the hotel. No one's allowed off the islands except us. The killer ain't going anywhere. Unless they jumped off the edge. And they got some way to fly. Huh. Didn't think about that.
Huh. Hello? They always start turning around.
You know, of all the places we've been, this is the closest I've felt to something that can work. This whole complex, I mean. They've got gainful employment, a wilderness reserve for fun, an enormous roof over people's heads. Maybe after the dust settles, they could shore up some holes and be an example to the rest of the colony. Here's hoping.
Here's hoping. Where's the good father? Whoops. Wow. Not used to how fast we run around. Ah, there he is. I didn't see you hunched over the desk there.
I welcome our opportunity to discover who killed Ms. Bellamy, but I fear the common serial theme of inspectors meeting out justice is as flimsy as their unconvincing storylines.
Hmm. Alright. Noted. I think I'll bring Parvati and the Padre there. Oops. Yeah. This is the old crew here. If it's brown, drink it down. So that's her. That's how I'm hearing things. Oh, there we go. Whoops. Alright. Frame rate. I remember the frame rate hits.
Is Inspector a higher rank than Captain? Just wondering whether congratulations are in order, Captain. Inspector?
No, Captain's gotta be higher.
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. Guilty as charged. What's occupying your thoughts?
Nothing.
I always wanted to see Eridanos. Sky above, sky below, horizons without end. Thanks for bringing me along, Captain. Yeah? I mean, what do you need?
Let me just restart here. The recording, I meant. Because every time we get those frame rate hits, it can lead to audio-video desync.
Oh, Captain, it's beautiful up like here. Could we get more jobs like this one?
Well, it depends. If this is multiple jobs, then yes. But it might be just one job. In which case, we're done after this. Hold on 1 second. Okay. Slug marksman.
Hello, hello, hello there. Hope your atmospheric entry wasn't too troublesome. As a guest of honor, you deserve the best in comfort. Sublight Salvage and Shipping Underground, or Slug, as we like to call ourselves, is delighted to welcome you to Eridanos.
Why would you like to?
I'm the Grand Colonial Head, Bellhop. I'm here to grab your bags and direct you, the Inspector, to the Grand Ballroom, which was the scene of the crime.
Why on Earth, or any other planet, would you like to be called Slug? Can you fill me in on the details of the murder?
I can try. I was the one who found Helen's body in the Grand Ballroom. Corpse wasn't in the best shape. Aside from that, I don't know a whole lot. Mm. Helen was supposed to host the unveiling for Rizzo's newest product, Spectrum Brown. Until you catch the killer, the unveiling's been indefinitely postponed. Helen's death has been a shock for many. A lot of people are inconsolable. Hell, even Black Hole Birdie, Helen's beau, has wandered off.
Black Hole Birdie?
Some folks think he had something to do with the murder, but I don't believe it.
I still don't understand why anyone would have it in for Ms. Helen.
The fans were very upset by the weak plot contrivances in her latest offering, though that hardly seems a worthy motive.
No.
Folks get heated when it comes to serials and their actors, I suppose.
Yeah, having a bad plot is not worthy of death. Was she a divisive figure at all? And by the way, the ex-husband, ex-boyfriend, whatever, boyfriend, husband, he's one of my key suspects. Was she a divisive figure?
Not particularly. But I think some folks were jealous of her success, or otherwise viewed her as a threat. Reckon how she came about her fame didn't help.
How'd she get famous?
Why, she was a natural. People fell in love with her. She managed to wrangle up a following all on her own. She ended up about as famous and high-runged as your average VP, which rubbed a lot of Byzantines the wrong way. Actors ain't supposed to get preferential treatment. Let's see here. Oh, I already spoke briefly about the Spectrum unveiling, or lack thereof. It's still an awful shame. A lot of folks looking forward to that.
I thought you worked for Slug, not Rizzo's.
I do. Rizzo's happened to rent out the Grand Colonial Ballroom from Slug for the unveiling. A nice mutually beneficial event. But the murder's gone and ruined that. Along with 9 out of 10 of my favorite cereals. Anyway, I think
crying.
I've held you up long enough. Once you're ready, head down to the lobby. The ballroom is just behind the elevators. Meanwhile, I'll grab your bags.
Bags? What bags?
You're making fun, right? Your luggage. Belongings, kit. Wherever you keep what you ain't wearing. You're still giving me a pretty blank look. Suppose it's none of my business, but do you just wear the same set of clothes all the time?
I just wear whatever I strip from my enemies' corpses, honestly.
Well, reckon I can respect your candor, even if it scares me a smidge.
Be afraid.
Anyhow, I'll look for you in the grand ballroom later.
Be very
Hope
afraid.
Hope you can unravel this mystery, Inspector.
Well, that was abrupt. Hail.
We don't toss troublemakers out of airlocks. We just throw them over the edge.
Well, yeah, this is open air, right? So, you wouldn't even need an airlock. Workbench, okay. It's an empty... Whoa. Okay, that was a delay. Wait. It's all coming back to me now. This is how we loot things. Oh! So they made a garden on this... whatever, skyship or something? Because we're in the atmosphere. So this is not really a spaceship or a space station, I don't think. Can I get in there? Oh yeah! Vortex Mace Ultra? Just remembered all the loot that we find in this. There's a lot of loot. Ratings.
Sublight Underground takes care of its own.
I'm sure they do. Sealed. Who said that? These people?
In or out until the murder investigation's concluded.
Do you have any idea who I am? I could bury you under 6 tons of paperwork before you had the time to cry out for your supervisor.
I'm sure you could, but we fed our last box of grievance forms into the incinerator a few months ago. Is there anything I can do for you in the meantime?
I cannot believe this.
Better believe it, baby.
I can't believe Helen's gone. We're never going to get a sequel to Terror on Monarch.
Maybe another actress?
I'm pretty happy working for Slug. Mr. Kin Cannon treats us with respect.
Are we allowed to just take stuff out of these? Immunosol? So apparently the answer is yes. No one's taking out guns and shooting us. So it's always a good sign.
I spent at the Grand Colonial. Is my patronage worth nothing to you?
My patronage.
I'm sure you've spent a lot, sir, but unfortunately we can't make any exceptions.
Can't make any exceptions. In Byzantium, those words would be a criminal offense.
Shame we're not in Byzantium.
That would have been my answer. Like, well, we're not in Byzantium now, are we? Sealed on that side as well. Yes, very nice. Really, I do.
I'm pretty happy working for Slug. Mr. Kincannon treats us with respect.
Thanks for the understanding.
I wasn't finished. Couldn't I just go out on a ship for a brief period? A handful of minutes, maybe? Just a quick trip to Byzantium so I can check on my stocks? I promise it won't take more than an hour.
Sir, for both our sakes, I'm just going to pretend like you didn't say anything.
I wonder what else this guy's going to say. Yeah, let's get in there. Alright, did I grab this? No, I did. Don't look at me like that.
Greetings, Inspector. No need to check in here. Your paperwork has all been processed. You should be able to find the Colonial right ahead. Sublight Underground appreciates your patronage.
The Dissident Queen, Chapter 1. Halcyon Helen battles a lingering foe in a seedy bar. Halcyon Helen and Typhon Tim spoke in quiet tones about their next course of action, their voices soft beneath the din of the bar. The duo had just finished the last of the paperwork on Helen's latest job. Filing precise reports always raised her spirits. The trails led us here, and I suspect they will lead us no farther. Soon we will find the source of the dissident's monsters, said Helen, a characteristic grin on her face. Let's hope your hunch is correct, Tim murmured, for I suspect their agents will not be far behind us. As if brought on by Tim's supposition, a frightful voice suddenly thundered throughout the room. Near the door loomed a giant and blood-stained man, looking for all his worth like he had fought his way through a Manta Queen's den. It was Maximilian Mercer, well-feared dissident stooge, and he held two Spacer's Choice light pistols in his greasy hands. His greasy little hands! Purple berry liqueur. Whiskey. Doors that don't do. Oh, wait. Oh, well, that goes somewhere up, but we're supposed to go this way. And we'll do that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.